Allora, abbiamo detto che questo community di maker in tutto il mondo si è attivato, l'ha fatto davvero in tutto il mondo, e abbiamo adesso una storia molto bella che viene dall'Africa, in particolare viene dal Kenya. Dovremmo avere un collegamento con Nairobi, credo che sia sì, con Nairobi, con due persone, la professoressa June Madete, che è un ingegnere biomedico, e col suo studente, che hanno realizzato qualcosa davvero di importante, Fidel Makatia Omusilibwa. Maybe. I'm sorry if I misspell your name. Sorry so much. Welcome to Rome.
Okay.
So, Professor June, the floor is yours.
Yes.
Just tell us this wonderful story.
Thank you very much for the introduction. I was following some of the English side of the conference, but
I know.
I think I've learned some of the Italian words. But my name is June Madete. I am a coordinator of biomedical engineering at Kenyatta University in Nairobi. We are new in engineering, so we started in 2008. And we now have from three departments, we have seven departments, we offer more than 10 courses. And when the pandemic happened, we tried to do our courses to make a difference and to innovate. So when the pandemic happened, our students came to us with an innovation and we were ready to help as mentors and financially. And our students formed a very multidisciplinary team of engineering, medicine, and nursing, and they came up with innovation. But the issue was, as engineers, we like going in our heads and we never try to document, and we needed documentation for validation. So we went to the Ubora. I've had something like Ubora with the last person who spoke live. And we used that platform to document, and it helped us through the steps of all the documentation necessary for our regulatory body to use. So Ubora helped us a lot in that process, from design, from needs assessment to design to operationalization. So from the last speaker, he just said the idea is to create this democratization of health, and Ubora is the forefront of that, and they're trying to create this Wikipedia of devices, and they helped us a lot because the steps were not used to. But with that in place, I would like to invite Fidel to take you through the journey the students went through from conception to implementation and to finally operationalization of the Kenyatta University Tibavent.
Fidel? So thank you, June. Fidel, welcome.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much. I was also following, but Italian is...
It's complicated, I know.
Yeah, it looks complicated. Yeah. So let me just... most of the things Dr. June has already talked about, so I'm just going to skip a lot here. So that is me. My name is Fidel Makatia. I'm a final year student of Electrical and Electronic Engineering in Kenyatta University in Nairobi, Kenya. So inspiration behind Tibavent is we wanted first COVID-19 pandemic, when it came from the first case in Kenya. So when the entire country was locked down, we wanted, as engineers and engineering students, to be a solution to the Kenyan society and also Africa at large, because the second problem is the scarcity of ventilators in Kenya. By then, Kenya had only 500 ventilators and the population of 50 million Kenyans. And this was a pandemic, which is a respiratory illness. So it was going to hit Kenya very bad. And also we had gained knowledge in school about machines and programming. So we wanted to put it into use. Of course, we had doctors also who have knowledge in physiology and pharmacy. So we wanted to put our knowledge into use, and also support from Kenyatta University, like what Dr. June said. The university proved to be very supportive. So all these combined together made us create Africa's first ever locally made ventilator. So the features, the most outstanding one, which is innovative, is our ventilator can be connected to an Android tablet. So it does, because Kenya has a shortage of medical personnel, the medical personnel to patient ratio is very low. So we created a device that can be, meaning one medical person can control more than one ventilator. So trying to, in isolation wards, trying to bridge that gap. And also the battery support, it can go up to 8 hours, because not most of the country has electricity. So we build a device which has a 8 hours backup battery. Of course, the other components are for a standard ventilator, the modes of ventilation, all the physiological parameters, including FiO2, PIP, PEP, and also triggers for SIMV. So it's also mobile and movable. It can move. So it also has a very graphical user interface. So it means it's very easy for the doctor to interact with it. It has 72 hours log support. So it's very easy to store logs and retrieve logs. It has alarms to protect the patient and the doctor. So it's a standard ventilator, but we have added remote access. So if you have an Android tablet or any kind of tablet, you can hook up into the ventilator. So Kenya also at that time had a shortage of PPEs. So it means that if you're a doctor in charge of an isolation ward, you don't have to go in. You can, if it's a minor alarm, you can address it from outside. So therefore, bridging that gap. So this is the layout of the ventilator. So look, you can see the left has a Android tablet for ventilation. And this is a short video of how it works. And you can see it's, that is a test lung. We use it to calibrate the ventilator. So the what is at the bottom is a battery, 8 hours battery backup, the graphical user interface. And that is a patient circuit. And the banner at the is a Ubora banner. At this time, we got a lot of support from Ubora. Of course, I'll talk about it. Daktari has also talked about it. Yeah. So benefits, main beneficiaries of the ventilator, health centers in Kenya. So in Kenya, ventilators are scarce by then. So it means only big hospitals can achieve because they're very expensive. So our ventilator, we made sure that we have engineered in such a way that we maintain the standard, but we cut the cost. So it means also dispensaries and health centers can also have the ventilators. So a solution center set aside by the government, also medical farms, and also institution of higher learning, because there are a lot of inventions and innovations done around it. So higher education institutions can actually do research and innovate about the same, and also learn other ways in which the science principles can be implemented in engineering. So how Bora made Tibavenda reality, you can see these are photos from the start. This, the lower left is actually the prototype. It was very huge and very heavy. Then we went up to the final product, the upper photo. So a team of 15 students. How Bora helped us is that we got a collaborative platform. So it basically means that we could work at the same thing from anywhere. So if people are not around, they could still work. So we can document and put documentation there. So somebody can just go check, read, and even refer. You can even assign assignments and get it. You can say, okay, this is your task for today. So it made us like we virtually were in the same room, although it might not be possible to be in the same room. So also ease of access of information. We had mentors on board. So the mentors could be able to advise. They were not with us. Some of them were even outside Nairobi, but they were able to advise and guide us through. So it was very flexible. So it means even on a Sunday evening or a Sunday morning, or even 3 a.m. in the morning, you're able to get advice and guidance from mentors. This is the team. We actually won the UN Person of the Year 2020 for creating the first ever African med ventilator. So from the bottom, you can see the team posing for our photo with the award. And the top is the team getting the certificate of calibration from Kenya Bureau of Standards. So this certificate basically implies that we have achieved all the standards laid by ISO and KEBS on ventilation, and it's a standard ventilator, and also things like ERC. We have a certificate for ERC, Ethical Review Committee, and also clinical trial. Thank you so much. I'm really impressed and happy to be here. Thank you.
So thank you. In 30 seconds, Professor Madete, are you there yet? Yes. All the world is waiting for the vaccines. And the northern countries of the world, they already bought them. Are you concerned or worried that in Africa they're going to arrive too late, and especially in Kenya? Or is not a problem? Or you're just... What do you think?
Okay,
Injustice.
It does, but we've learned from this pandemic, because we've learned that we are capable and we have the information and the knowledge. So I am feeling, yes, that we are being left behind, but also our numbers are not as high. So yeah. I think we can continue to collaborate, continue to be, don't forget about us, because at the end of the day, you need Africa. We run and we laugh and we smile and we are strong.
So. That's very good. So, Fidel, your achievement this year has been huge. What's your big dream for next year?
So after launching a medical machine, we realized, like what Dr. Madete is saying, that we are capable. So it has actually inspired us and me personally to innovate around local problems, but creating solutions that can be used anywhere in the world. Actually, if you look around the activities I'm doing, actually creating stuff which people did not know can originate from Africa.
And so, June, Fidel, this speech is worth like a flight to Rome next year for the next Maker Faire in presence, okay?
Wow.
So we're waiting for you there. Okay?
Thank you.
Thank you so much.